Pedestrian killed. Eyewitness News has learned new details in a story we first reported yesterday.
Smithfield police are now taking action to try and revoke the license of a man who struck and killed a young girl Sunday.
Eyewitness News has learned that the identity of that 12-year-old girl was visiting from Guatemala.
And that girl's family, who is now here in Rhode Island, will honor their daughter's memory tonight. Eyewitness News reporter Susan Campbell has been tracking this story since yesterday and joins us with more on what she's learned from Smithfield.
The victim is now being identified as Daniela Heredia. We've learned her parents arrived here in Rhode Island from Guatemala early this morning, and we're told they're planning on participating in a special memorial mass for their daughter tonight. Mangled black metal lays on the sidewalk on Putnam Pike, marking the place where a little girl was hit by a car Sunday afternoon. Smithfield police say Daniela Heredia was walking along Route 44 with a group of girls when the driver of this black Honda Accord jumped the sidewalk and crashed into her. Police tell us the 12-year-old was thrown over the guardrail and into a rocky ditch. People who live nearby rushed to help.
I saw this little girl laying in the gully, and my immediate reaction was to get down to her, to comfort her, to just stay with her, to let her know that help was on the way.
Rescue crews took Heredia to Hasbro Children's Hospital, where she died a short time later. We've learned she had just arrived from Guatemala for a week-long camp at Mater Ecclesia College in Greenville.
What I know about Daniela is that she was very excited to come to camp. She actually told her friends, I just want to go to Rhode Island to get to know Christ better.
Now camp organizers are trying to cope with the tragedy.
We're asking for prayers. We'd be very happy if everyone out there could pray for the Heredia family, for the driver of the car, for all the girls. They were just shocked seeing their friend and very hurt.
Smithfield police tell Eyewitness News they have not filed any criminal charges against the 80-year-old driver, but they say they will be asking the Department of Motor Vehicles to revoke the man's license. There were two other girls who were also taken to the hospital yesterday with minor injuries. We're told they were released from the hospital last night. Reporting in Smithfield with the Northwest Mobile Newsroom, Susan Campbell, Eyewitness News.